Let me plug in all the devices. If you don't recognize the guy who is showing up the webcam, today I'm taking over for Karda. Karda had to go somewhere. So, hello everybody. I'm Karda version 2.0. If you didn't notice. Hello and welcome back to a new stream / recording. Also trying to record this for YouTube later. Hello, Katie UK. Thank you very much for joining and being here as well. It is. That's all my. Oh, Katie. Yeah. I need to go to my parents this weekend. And my mother hates it. My mother hates a beard, and my father has a beard as well. So I definitely removed it because A, I don't want to be associated with my father. Hey, he's a good guy. I mean, I love my father, I love my daddy. But when you go to him, you don't want to be like, hey, I'm just like you, you know. That's so. And my mother hates the beard as well. So yeah, exactly. I was like, hey, if Sepp can do it, I mean, he sounds so much older than he is in real life, but I'm not going to say that to him. I think, hey, maybe I can do it as well. So that's, yeah, exactly. So, here is the other card. I think I, yeah, exactly. Yeah, that, I think that's what it is, Katie. Yeah, we're all getting older. But, yeah, in mom's eyes, and I'm quite blessed with the parents I have, thank goodness. I hear so many horrible stories from other people. Broken up families, parents on drugs, parents on alcohol. I heard them, yeah, we all heard them all. And at one point in your life you realize, hey, how, yeah, for me at least, how blessed I am. It's just when you're growing up, especially from 15 to 18 or 19, you think you know always you know everything better. But I think that's a phase for everyone. And so, those years didn't go so well. Let's call it like that. You know, it's always ups and downs. But then you start to get older, and they are starting to get older and wiser as well. So, thank goodness. It's just my mom. She is not doing very fine at the moment. So, this weekend I'm gonna increase my visits a little bit. I mean, if I go there each month, I only get to see them. What is it? 12 times a year, and that feels like. You know what is 12 times a year for the years that we still have in the future, maybe that already feels like it's not a lot, you know. So but let's go back to Train Simulator. I think that's the smartest way to go. I hope I got some interesting. Well, I think I got some interesting. We're not gonna finish that class 43 to London. I'm gonna do it on my own time or another day, but not in prime time. Two viewers, prime time. So I got, like the title said, I'm definitely gonna play that Rosgar on the Southern Expressways. That's definitely first go. We're gonna drive a class 52 there. Then somebody recommended yesterday, I think it was Jelly. Hey Machiavelli, goedenavond. Huh. Machiavelli rolls into the house with an opa. Thank you Machiavelli for the support of the channel. So let's enjoy opa for a couple seconds. I'm not in a hurry. It's still early. And that's the story of opa. He worked all. Yeah, if you don't know, I'm gonna repeat it one more time. It's a comedy movie from the Netherlands, and opa, he worked for the Dutch Railroads is all life. And well, yeah, that's how we...
Are you
That's how it ended for Opa.
Ready? Let's get ready,
let's get ready to rumble. So we're going to start off with Rosgar. I'm always impressed by Rosgar scenarios. The amount of static and AI. But the it doesn't end. I should make a cup so Machiavelli can donate bits instead. How would that be? Yeah, I'm always impressed by Rosgar. But some scenarios just AI crashes or... But that's probably because some scenarios are quite old and routes do change. Boom Time by... how was he called again? Coasty was recommended by Jellybean. So that's on the list as well. And
why am I toxic?
And I think I found a Sync scenario on UK Train Sim. The Sync has been making good scenarios already on Steam Workshop. And I think he posted it yesterday or the day before. It's going to be West Scotland Line. Well, at least we're going to do the Rosgar and the Boom Time on Scotland. From Coasty. And after that we'll see how much spirit is left and how far we are in time. So it's going to be, yeah, that's definitely, it's going to be a diesel evening. So... Yeah, I'm not gonna change the audio values now.
So I made the least I ever made on YouTube in January and February. It just got even down on YouTube.
That's the best one, Machiavelli.
Extra money to pay these taxes coming up, and I'm just beginning the money to pay my bills. Where's the tax money gonna come from?
Okay. So that's the plan. Let's go back in the game. The only thing left to do is synchronize the clock, and then we're gonna start off with the Rosgar scenario on the Southern Expressways route by Just Trains. Synchronize the clock at 11:28. I think I can do it. How did I do it again? With the Y? No. Oh my god, I forgot. Oh, really? Wow, my memory is really going... I forgot the key to set the time. J. Yeah. Yeah. The J of go. What time did I say? 11:34? Oh. Let's see. 11:34. No. 11:28:30. 11:28:34 seconds. Right. That gives us a half minute to prepare in the game. Let's start the clock. Come back in the game. And we're, of course, we're going to do one more of... this and then
are you ready?
And we should be able to go.
Let's get ready to rumble.
We are starting at Bristol Temple Beach actually. Let's open some doors. On a bright but showery June morning, the volume of the train is loud, you start off waiting in Bristol. We are departing at 11:33. A couple of late running services are in front of you, so don't expect all greens today. It should be fairly straightforward. Otherwise, just make sure you run to time or you may have to wait for the rest of the branch. Will do. Now let's look a little bit around then. I think this is the charm always of Rosgar scenarios. The amount of diesel, static, stuff happening everywhere. Here we got what are you? A 45. This should be a 101. I think. Could also be the other one. Yeah, trains coming and going. They're so really good scenario I love them too. Oh, it's a 47. Hey, Des. Oh, whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop, man. Oh, the beast. Look at that beauty. The length of the train ain't. Oh, that's just another one. What are you? Western Lady. That's also a 52, I think. I know. What a... But hey, if you enjoy it. Yeah, it's a world of trains. And hello beauty. You are. Oh, 47. There's a sad story about this train we are going to drive. The 47 lost power. So they called in a class 52. Western Prince to pull the 47 and the coaches. So that's actually not so good news for the 47. Really sad day. That's basically the story of this scenario. There she goes, our Western Lady. Have a good journey. Yeah, I don't need real time table scenarios. This is what we're here for. Lots of trains, stuff happening, static stuff. So let's enter the cabin and see how a 52 drives. I don't think I've driven them. Actually, yeah, 1 minute to test the scenario. Oh, we got the lovely bell. The brakes have been released already. And request a past danger is denied. Let's hope it doesn't. Okay, yeah, we are behind the other passenger train. We had a sound of the engine is too loud, or my microphone is too loud, or anything. It's really appreciated if you let me know. It's always so hard to keep. Each train is so more loud, or some are just way noisier than other ones. I hope it isn't red. Look at those, are old coaches. What are you? No clue. No time. I need to brake. Oh no 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 no. Yeah, emergency. Yeah, I thought so. I'm gonna make a macro for that. I'm gonna reduce the game with 6 decibels. Yeah, the game is so loud. This is what I call doing a seeker. Yeah, I'm gonna continue. I hope this doesn't kill the scenario. I hope the signals are just... So I'm gonna continue slowly then. Oh, do I hear another train? I hope not. Oh, wow. We got one. Well, and that's not bad timing, because I was downing, we got a dump. Bang, exactly. It didn't like me driving through the red signal, I guess. Wow. That's been a long while. Well, yeah, yesterday it happened, but that was basically because that one scenario was a bit unstable. So let's do this again. Let me see. It's the Southwestern Expressways. Then we got to find the Class 52. 1976 going western. One last time. Yeah, that was, we ended with a bang. Yeah, Des, did you buy that that new route from Dovetail? Because Scotty went back to the other train simulator for that new US route. What made you go back, Des? Yes, this is the plan, but this time I'm just gonna put on some brakes so we are sure the passengers will board safely. You are so right. We're gonna put it at 11:29:30. 29, well, make it 20. Yeah, thank you very much, Katie. Now the clock is 5 seconds ahead. That's not a biggie. Yeah. Yeah, so many trains indeed, Des. And you are the Thunderer. Ha! Very appropriate name. Yeah, I mentioned that yesterday. Roska always managed to include something in a scenario you don't have. And for this one, I had to buy a blue 08 shunter from the marketplace on Steam for €4. I could have RW tools them out and put a green one in, but I was like, no. For the €4, okay, I'll just buy the blue reskins. It still looks nice. I will never drive it any myself. I'm not a shunter type of guy. So he had a pool 47. And the driver still inside as well. Not much he can do now. I think we got our lady back. Yeah, look at this blackness from the smoke. It's really cool. I think that's quite realistic. Oh, from the clack. A really nice touch. Yeah, this is... so old that even the colors have gone, or what? I don't know. This looks very weird. I think the thing is you lived everywhere. Maybe that's the reason. View. So this scenario made me buy the Southern Express race from Just Trains. It was a route, it was still on my list of I want to buy it one day. And then I noticed Wolfgar made this scenario, but I don't know when. Could be a long time ago already. I was like, yeah, now I got finally a good reason to buy the route. Over 24 years? Oh, I hope... who is it again? One of my moderators. Forgot his name. Whoopsie. Not Padoka, but the other guy. He lives in Bristol now. He's a Dutch guy. And he's doing a study in Bristol. Oh yeah, Simulator Dash. I agree. Oh, that's a steal. What a shame I already have it. Where's the brake balance? Oh, is the red? Okay, the red dial. Red ahead. Right on. Safe progress. Oh yeah. Now let's continue. Oh well, I did. I already did. Yes, I know, Des. I already broke Twin Simulator 5 minutes ago. Yeah, the sale on Dovetail is 5 days. So my plan is to wait to Friday evening and see if there's anything on sale on Just Trains or on Steam, and then see if I'm gonna buy. Am I going to spend my money on those two Japanese routes, which I really, really want to do, actually, or buy something else if there's a sale on AP or Just Trains. So thank goodness the sale on Dovetail Games is not for one day. It lasts until Monday, if I'm correct. Now we are in the green zone. Let's go. Oh, I love the bell. Yeah, it's nice, right? Even more windows than a 47. So if there's nothing else, I'm gonna buy those Japanese routes. I already calculated for both. Now it's 21 euros to buy the Wakazaki and the two. I don't know what they are called, but those two Japanese lines. And then before I'm gonna drive him, I'm gonna look a manual how to reskin a train. And reskin that Japanese train with my favorite manga. I'll put my favorite manga, Japanese manga figurines on the loco. The egg fried, right? That's the one. Yeah, how could I forget? Yeah, I got a reskin. Before I'm gonna drive it, I need that to have a reskin I want. And that train doesn't look hard to reskin, it's just a brick. What an ugly train. They have, well, these are older ones, I think, from the Japanese lines. I think one of your UK trains is already nicknamed Flying Brick. But if you see those trains, that green one. That That's Rhelium, so that should be hard to retexture. It's just finding out how to convert a texture file to BMP. And then copy paste some stuff on it and then convert it back to GeoPix, or I don't know how it's called in the train sim. Okay, one yellow. Then it's break time. The plan is to reduce to 30. Just to be sure. Yeah, I enjoy this 10 times as much as driving a 43. I mean, it's quite nice, the distance from Plymouth to London. That's not a problem, but I've done enough 43s, I think, maybe. I hope not. But that's such a different thing than playing something like this. Still one yellow. Oh wow. Let's enjoy this. It's a 47. Whoop whoop. That 47 still drives. Yeah. Sim, it is. I hope you are driving it with AP. It's a beast. I hope you found the money to at least get the Valenta and the MTU. I don't know if you already got those. No, we're still in one yellow. Not gonna take any chances. Oh yeah. Yeah, we need more scenarios from the blue era. That would be awesome. A 43 in the intercity livery in the blue era, driving from Plymouth to London. There's a small problem. Yeah, it's quite hard to find a timetable from back in those days. As detailed as RTT does now. That would quite help. So I guess it's gonna be, imagine a not real timetable for such, and it's such a long ride. I think I see something green between it. Yeah, it's green now. Okay, we gotta speed up a bit now. No, we are estimated 1:30 early. Awesome. Yeah, what I was telling about that real tour next year, it's not if I have the money, that's not a problem next year, but it's the one thing is, am I willing to spend the money for a holiday and a real tour next year? That's after 2 weeks, the holiday is over and the money is gone. Then I'm like, yeah, with that money I can buy stuff that I can enjoy for a longer time, you know. Yeah, it's of course you want to if it's a 2 week journey, of course it's the train tickets, but I think the most expensive is you gotta sleep, you gotta find a place to sleep, and that adds up if you want to sleep in a hotel or something for 14 days, well, in different towns or cities, of course. Yeah, that adds up. Then I'm like, ooh, that's just for the hotels. Yeah. Sleep on the train. Yeah, I can take the Caledonian. How is it called? Wow. Yeah, but I'm gonna miss out on so many places I want to visit as well on the West Coast Main Line. I don't even know why they're still driving, those Caledonian sleepers. This is another scenario I still have to complete, that the big sleep. With the 92 I only played the first part yet. I still have to play part 2, 3, 4 and 5. But 2 I am gonna skip because it's way too dark. Yeah, maybe in my own time. Western Prince. I would have preferred the lady. What's that lady called again? Which we met 20 minutes ago. But okay, Western Prince has to do. Yes, exactly, that is... I'm definitely gonna save, yes, please. Yeah, so far all the scenarios for Wolfgar are a bit in the older diesel days. So, really, really nice. Oh, wow. Well, then I think I'm gonna skip on that, if you don't mind, Des. That's a lot of money, man. I can buy a G. Yeah, if you're making $10,000 a month, hey, that's peanuts. But, yeah, I'm not making 10K a month. I should start streaming Fortnite. I call myself the Dutch Ninja. No, but that dude has skills. I must admit, man, that he makes way money, but he does have skills. I mean, that building of Ninja, that's insane how fast. There we go. That's basically the audience. But who cares if you can make, well, he is making more than 10,000 a month. What are you? Express parcels? Yeah, never a boring moment in Oscar scenarios. And they are a couple, right? How lovely. They are sharing the same interest. Sorry about the small wait. Ain't no problem. I am no problem. Some difficult SLF. Okay. Yeah. It is. It is. If you do it for a year, you'll never have to work again. At least if you got like Des and the other guy, I don't know, because I'm not following him. Dr. Disrespect. Yeah, that's the other dude. So yeah, every young boy wants to become a streamer for a living. Totally understandable. I get the impression this is actually looking like a quite beautiful route. Not 1 million trees and forests, but just nice landscaping. I think this part looks better on the expressways than on the Western Mainline. But that's just a feeling. What's the guy called with the blue hair? Ninja, is it? Yeah, that's Ninja. It's, yeah. It's beautiful. Yeah, Somerset is on sale now as well. But I can't make myself buying them. Because they are so short. So it's gonna be Japanese lines or a Somerset. Or maybe a sale on AP or Just Range. I'm gonna wait till Friday. It's gonna be one thing or the other, not everything at once. Give me motion sticks. Halo. Then I would not recommend playing Fallout 76. Hey Chris Shields. Hey, nice. Nice to see you, man. I'm glad you're here for a moment. I don't know for how long. It's very nice to see you. Enjoyed your stream yesterday. So, yeah, you kept it real. It's very nice. Hey, Kojo62. Hello. Hello and welcome. Welcome to our Oscar scenario. Maybe I was a bit. I spoke what I thought, you know, yesterday. You know, there were so many fake accounts on. There's still 1 hour. There are so many fake accounts on Twitch. Everybody can call himself Rail Driver, Engineer, or Rail Driver. You know. Oh, no problem. So I definitely wasn't sure if that was a real Rail Driver guy who entered my stream yesterday. Hey, 994. So I just spoke my mind, you know, I'm never gonna shout or say negative things. I just spoke my mind like, hey, I would like an XL version, which is basically what it is. And it took him so long to make the driver, but then I watched your stream. And I saw what they improved on their on what they have. My English is so bad. I noticed what they have accomplished with what they are doing now with the 64-bit driver, supporting Arms on Powerhouse, trying to support the most range with all the scripting. I was not aware of that. Still, I think they should have released just a fix when the 64-bit was released. But I must say, I was quite impressed how they are work. So that's a positive thing, and I just wanted to share that with you. It was quite nice to see how they are working now on making the most range compatible. So there you go. And like I said, I wasn't shouting yesterday, but I just said, yeah, Third Wheels was fixed in a day, but that's a different ballgame, I understand, than a driver for a controller. So, I'm not taking back my words, but I just wanted to share that, hey, what I've seen yesterday on your stream, I was quite impressed. Yeah. Yeah. And I said, hey, I was like, that's a fake account. I can also make an account real driver tech engineer, you know. Yeah, I'm, but he was the true thing. So yeah, sorry to hold up the chat a little bit there. That's just so I'm glad you're here a little bit, Chris, because it's easier to talk than to type in the chat, which I of course yesterday I just came and listened and watched. I'm not gonna disturb anything, especially when the showcasing was going on. I just hope, Chris. Yeah, he said, hey, they have a real life sized thing in their office. Well, that's a bit too XL. But a little bit more XL wouldn't hurt. I would, yeah. If it was just a little bit bigger, Chris. Just a little bit. But, yeah. It's so good to see that, especially Armstrong Powerhouse trains are working. And okay, maybe the speed dial maybe isn't working for Armstrong Powerhouse, but that's not. I mean, we got that information on the screen as well. Hey, eh? That's not the most important part of a rail driver. To have the speed readout, it's nice that it works on other trains, and if it doesn't work, that's. It's not killing the device. But that is actually working now. Yeah. And that's what I said yesterday as well. Dovetail Games should have spent more time making their game compatible with Rail Driver. They like spending their time on making it compatible with a controller. But hey, I understand, but it's also a simulation. There are also diehard real driver freaks. Yeah, I would never drive this with a controller myself. Then keyboard, yeah, I'll just go keyboard. Yeah, and that's not the major part. Chris, I wouldn't care if the wipers and light switches don't work, man. I will press the H on the keyboard for the headlights, or just do it with the mouse. It's the most important is the throttle, the brake. Well, even the the shifting up, man. That was also cool, by the way, on the 101. That little thingy, you can shift up and down. Are we going to be on time here? Yeah, we are. Okay, then we're just going to continue. Rolling out a bit. Western Supermare. I remember somebody told me yesterday. Katie, we are back. We are back here. I think, I think this part looks better in the Southern Expressways than it does in the west on the Western Mainlines. It is just a feeling. I haven't driven both enough, but I got a good feeling about this. So yeah, this is my first time I'm driving the Southern Expressways. Oh, Van Roskar has the hand of God. Yeah, I've been in our last 3 days. I think it's a really, really nice part of this route. With that, what is it? 80 degrees turn. Yeah, 80. Really nice. Yeah, this is. I knew it from. I already told it a couple of times. I love the diesel. I love this era. Really do. I think tomorrow I might be tempted to buy the sale and pick up a few bargains. Yeah, I'm gonna wait till Friday. If Just Strange or Armstrong Powerhouse decides to do a black sale. A Black Friday sale, then yeah, Japan has to wait. Those two routes, and I'll just go for something, something there. Oh, have fun, Katie. Well, we'll try to keep you entertained while it's always nice to do stuff like that while watching a stream. Hey, Synx is driving. At the moment, he's also really cool, and I got him on my list to maybe play this evening one of his scenarios as well. Let's see what is. He is going from London King's Cross to Leeds, at least in a 91. Yeah, Dovetails started their sale quite early. But then it's gonna last for 5 days, so we can still wait. Yeah, we're gonna wait 2 days, there's at least I am. It would be a shame to find out like, hey, now there's a sale. And I can't buy anything because I bought the two Japanese routes. Well done so far. Now some faster running. Oh, alright. Stop at Bridgewater though. If the channel out of Western Loop is red, try a tap. Alrighty. Well, at least let's save. And hit the road, Jack. Yeah. But I guess we gotta wait for Christmas. For AP and Just Trains. CK and Jelly are both recommending that fictional route from Just Strange. Yeah, I'm gonna hide it. Oh, there's. But the fictional route is 25 euros. And if it would have been 8 or 10, I'm not sure if I'm gonna enjoy. It could be the best route in the world, but it's still fictional. I'm like, yeah. I don't know what's called. Something with an M. I think it was something with an M. Like, yeah. But not for 25 euro. Yeah, there's. I agree, man. I really agree. Is that red? Or is that the glow? Don't tell me, eh? That can't be. Did we hit the yellow? Oh, baby, please. Stop now. Wait, that's the one. Yeah, alright. Yeah, okay. That's the one they were telling me about to tap. Well, nothing lost, nothing gained. Let's go. We shall pass. You got that right, Des? I think it's quite worth it, Katie. That Devon and Cornwall. I haven't tried it myself. I've seen 994 stream it. The main line, and it looked really gorgeous. Yeah, it is. It is, Katie. Now with, first we got that 7.0 update. Oh, now my television needs a firmament. A meddling about reskins. That is a good time for it now. With that 7.0 update, I don't know if there were any requirements added. The list was already so long, and hey, I just can't remember, of course, what I remember installing everything for 6.0. I hope it's the same requirement wise, because to download everything and install it again. Yeah. Yeah, it piles up and it piles up. Yeah, it's the reskins. I do not like when reskins use a .bat file to install their stuff. I don't like that. I myself prefer the manual thing, because with some .bat files, they are assuming I haven't extracted the AP file, so they are trying to copy stuff from the AP file, which isn't there, because I extracted everything. So yeah, I prefer not having a .bat file myself. And when there's a .bat file, I always go to modify and check out what are they doing, and then I'll do it myself. Yeah. Yeah, I got it on G, but at least not on C. Yeah. I also try to keep it away from my Windows drive. On a separate drive, just there's only train sim on it. And the size, it keeps growing and growing and growing. The gigabytes, I think last time I made a backup it was 470,000 files. I mean, that's 500,000 of files. Incredible. Is there maximum speed, by the way, in this lovely train? I can't find any sign here. I'm gonna assume it's 95. That's a lot. Some people have 400. I went to Steam. And I disabled all the German and US routes. I said, no, I'm not gonna play those at the moment anyway. So I just removed all the US and German routes. Just make them disappear from my... when I wanna play them, I can always enable them again in Steam. Very convenient. I think I really... Oh, that's another meme I want to add, by the way. I think I can. I think this route is detail-wise. This part, I think I love this more than the Western. Yeah. Yeah, that would surprise me. Yeah, then I really need to transfer everything to another drive. It's now running on 256 gigabyte SSD. But once that runs out, I gotta transfer it to the 1 terabyte. And the day is getting... That day is getting closer and closer, especially with all the freeware routes and stuff. And then I buy a route here and a route there. It goes so quickly. But that's the best update this game can have. If you do not have an SSD, they have dropped in price so much lately. It's a world of difference for loading tiles. Ah, there he is. It's always when you talk about the devil, you step on his tail. At least that's a Dutch saying. I don't know if the saying is in English as well. Hey, Jake. Good evening, Jake. Hope you're doing fine, man. Hello, man. you're talking about the size of Train Simulator. On the hard drive. What is this for a honk? Oh, I like this one better. Doing fine, Jake. I'm doing... Look at these windows. I mean... I'm totally in my element. I can see trees left, right, in front. This terrain is hellfire. I'm still not... Hey, I'm still the 47 guy. But... This ain't bad. This ain't bad at all. What's the maximum speed, Jake? 95 for 52? It doesn't go faster than 92 anyway. But what is the... Is there some kind of hard speed limit like there is in the 47? Let's go off the throttle now. Prepare for Bridgewater. Oh, what a lovely journey this is. 90. Alright, Jake, thank you. I have been looking if there's a sign somewhere. Most of the time there's something that tells, hey, look. But no, couldn't find any. Well, maybe there. Important to obtain train pipe fact. No, there's nothing about speed. Oh, wait a second. I'm just... There we go. Emergency brake. Another exclamation mark fail. Go on, baby, you can do it. If we hit the platforms at 30, we are. I think I can. Yeah. Okay, but I'm not gonna open the doors here. Come on, baby. Ah, we found it. It found the correct gear. Struggling a little bit there. And time wise, we're still on time. There you go. And save. Yeah, this is her. This is it. This is him, Jake. Delta, it's pronounced Delta. Delta 1041. The Western Prince. And we are, yeah, that's the sad part, Jake. The story is this 47 lost power. So we are using this train. It's actually, maybe some headlights would be nice for the other train. 47 lost power, and we're now pulling the 47 and the coaches towards Exeter. Let's hit it. If you're still here, Chris, I'm totally ready, man, for your scenarios. When the day comes, I think I got the requirements now. With that FOV on top of it. What a horrible FOV the game has. When you don't change the INI file. So how did that minus 5 degrees turn out, Jake? Did it come, or were they quite wrong with their predictions? I checked here as well, but we were having 6 degrees or something, so... Over here the temperatures were quite okay. It is. And it's also quite good for the engine, by the way. We're not running full RPMs. Oh, I know the drill. We know the drill, Katie. Yeah, it's hard labor. Okay, Des. Thank you very much, man. Enjoy the evening. And definitely see you next time, man. Always good to see you. Timetable not. Okay, the last part is gonna be very... It's just high speed stuff. This is we're halfway now. Yeah, if you find some interesting scenarios for the Devon and Cornwall, Katie. If you think like, hey, this could be an interesting one, you're always welcome to chat them in Steam or in Twitch. As long as it isn't a 158 or any EMU or DMU, I just don't like them very much. But I have no clue what trains are driving there, so I'm just calling random numbers here. Yeah, that 90 mile per hour is not a bad thing, Jake. The engine is way less loud now. Instead of cooling going all in all the time. It's much, much quieter. Oi! Hey Jellybean. Hello and good evening. I hope you're doing. Thank you for joining in. Especially at this time of day, I think it's quite prime time at the moment for streamers. And I kicked off my stream, Jelly, with the wolf car. 60, okay, gotcha. With a Ross car scenario on the southern expressways. It's gonna bring us from Bristol to Exeter. And what a nice job those two people are doing with their scenarios. And it's my first time driving in a Class 52. And it's my first time driving the Southern Expressways. So, and it's a great era. But driving in BR Blue era, well, it's sheer awesomeness. Awful white horse. Yeah, I think it's called the Black Prince. Something. I know you. That's not what you're referencing. I would have preferred the other model, which was nicknamed some kind of lady. That's alright, we'll take the Prince. And we are pulling. Yeah, what I mentioned yesterday, jelly brings tears in my eyes. We are pulling a 47 who lost power. And the coaches, it should have... the 47 and its coaches. Mesbury, looks more like a lamb. Thank you. Back on time. Again, we're gonna save. I don't like DOMS. I used to drive this thing so much on the wear day of these deal. But that's 2 years ago. What an awesome train that was. What an awesome train that was. Awesome route everywhere as well. And this is Roscar. This is Roscar. Static stuff, trains moving everywhere. You are old boy. We need a cleaning. It's, oh, that's the 37, Jake. But it really needs some cleaning. Yeah. Yeah, that's gone. There's the action. I stand on the... Oh, you are you're cargo. Whoop, whoop. Yeah. So there's that poor 47. In real life they would never break down. No way. So we have been called in. Yeah, hey, look at this is really nice reskinning. Oh no, it's not even a reskin, it's a Western Hydraulics, isn't it? Hello Paul, 5972. Hello and welcome. Were you able to get dirt wheels working, Paul? Oh, I need to go to the bathroom, guys. Give me 1 minute, please. Gladly, I was able to find a porter cabin close by on the platform. So we made it back in time. I think it was you who asked about, yeah, third wheels. Yeah, you got it working, seems to run okay. Well. Gotta get some as well. The coffee cart was stalled next to the port of the cabin. Next stop is Exeter, as a local train in the bay will stop at Tiverton. Beware of the speed restrictions into Exeter. Got you there, Roscar. Okay, I'm gonna wait for the brakes. It's an amazing tool, that third rails map. And it's so easy to install and to work with it. And I told other people as well, my awareness of towns and cities in the UK is below zero. So it helped me so much give an outsider some awareness where I'm driving. Because yeah, of course we know where London is. At least that basic knowledge. I was quite aware where London was, but for the rest. So it helped me quite a lot. Yeah, you were trying to make third rails or something else, eh, Paul? There was something else you were working on? What's happening? Oh! That's why the sign is here. No smoking. Ah, well, yeah, that's I wasn't paying attention. So now we're in an oopsie moment. Hey, Scotty, you arrived at the right time. Oh, now I hope we didn't screw up the scenario by this. I mean, that was one of the worst paddings you can imagine. Now, where's the next signal? Ah, the broadcasting, yeah. Okay, we're gonna assume it was red because of that rain. Hey, somebody noticed. Well, Carda is having a day off, Scotty. So he asked me to take his place for this evening. So that's it. And of no. And of course, I didn't have to buy a train this week, so I could spend my money on the on those cheap shaving things. Instead of buying a train, I was able to buy something to shave with. Maybe your stream will be better. That's not, yeah, maybe. I'm afraid not. It's gonna be the same color. Oh, this pad was horrible. I think it's kind of some real, yeah, it is. So yeah, the old car that will be back, I guess, in a month. It's gonna take a month or two. Oh, let's please don't let it be another red. No, it's green. All right, finally. Let's save this thing for just to be sure. Yeah, it finally came through for me now, Scotty. That sale you were mentioning on DGG, when you were mentioning it, it didn't show up for me. Yeah, I was like, oh, Scotty is just kidding. I mean, Fishing Simulator was on sale for me, but the rest wasn't at that time. Yeah, I think they just did a copy paste of the monster sale. But I'm gonna wait, that's what I said to Des as well. I'm gonna wait until Friday. if by any slight minor chance Just Trains or Armstrong Powerhouse is doing a Black Friday sale, so I'm keeping the money now. And if there's nothing on sale this Friday on Just Trains and Armstrong Powerhouse, I will buy the two Japanese routes. Yeah, that's because the Dovetail game sales lasts until Sunday or something. So there's no hurry at the moment. It's not for one day. So if there's no sale on Just Trains and AP, it's gonna be Japan, baby. Konnichiwa. Driving a green brick. And those trains are really ugly. Yeah. Yeah, I gotta visit my parents this weekend. And that's basically the reason. My mother hates the beard. So that's reason one. And my father has a beard as well. So each time if I go to my parents, I just make sure there's no beard. But I love my old man, don't get me wrong. But it's just, hey, that's too much honor. Oh, that's the first thing my mother always says. Oh, you got a beard again. But that in Dutch, of course. It's what I mentioned in the start of the stream to Katie as well. I'm quite blessed with my parents. Sometimes you hear so many awful stories. People who have grown up with a drugs addicted parent, or one who is drinking a lot, or yeah, that's just two examples, but there are so many examples. You think, oh, yeah, glad I didn't have to go through that myself. Edwin Aartsen. Goedenavond, Edwin. He's waving a raid icon. Thank you for joining, Edwin. I'm just playing a little bit of train. I enjoy Train Simulator at the moment very much. And so here I am, playing, streaming, and the best part is the nice community of the Train Sim. The community on Twitch for Train Sim is that's basically the most fun. Hey, it is fun to play the game, don't get me wrong, but it's the community that makes it so much more fun. So I'm playing a Rolls car scenario in the BR Blue era, the old diesels. I love it. What an era. But yeah, that's with the Dutch railways as well. But that's also because of my age, of course. I mean, yeah, the Honda Cop. Yeah, the Mod 45. Awesome. With the green seats and the smoking cabin, especially the smoking cabin. Back in those days, it was no problem. If you you're smoking. Well, if we haven't got the smoking cabin for you. Always the good atmosphere in the smoking cabin. Yeah, the 54s, awesome. And back in those days, where you drove them, it was just normal and there was nothing special. But yeah, of course we're getting older. Everybody's getting older. No exception there, but yeah. Now it's more like, wow, yeah. Did our Mandy mention, I love the smoking cabin? Yeah, those days. And now I gotta stand on the platform at the smoking pile, or how do you translate that in English? I can't even smoke on the platform. I need to find a smoking pillar outside on the platform in the wind. Otherwise I'll get a ticket of 70 euros. It's what a difference back then and back now. So I'm at the moment really in my element. Let's showcase this. Where's that button? 4? Yeah, 4. And then 8 for free cam. Yeah, beautiful. '52 when we are pulling a 47 and his coaches. There were some kind of engine problems with the 47, which normally never happened in real life. Of course, but they were so reliable. It's one of my favorite trains, so. 47. I love that thing. The downside is with these big windows, it's the rendering of, because everything has to be pushed in a 3 Mbit upload. So if you're driving a 158, there's so much less rendering needed. And that will fit through 3 Mbit no problem, but with these wide windows, yeah. I'm afraid it can get very blurry. But the drive is amazing. think, no, we're not gonna make it in time. Ah well. Back in these days, 2 minutes were just peanuts. Train Repairman 54 for a couple of days. I've not seen him stream as well. I hope he's doing fine. Around the 90 miles an hour. Do one more save. Hey. Quite nice, Paul. And what's your journey gonna be for today? Still driving about, and I see a 2 Alpha 65 south of London. Yeah, I had it with, I downloaded Third Rails and installed it 2 days later. The 6S904 Preston to Carlisle. Ah, you're gonna do the West Coast Main Line over Shep. Awesome route. Wrong there. Just gotta swipe my screen a little bit up, because that part of England wasn't on my screen, now it is. So I installed it and 2 days later I started using it, but it didn't broadcast. But then in between those 2 days there was an update, B-Train made an update to Third Rails. Just in those 2 days, that the old version didn't broadcast anymore because he changed some stuff. So I was like, why is it not working? Why is it not working? And then somebody told me, yeah, you need a new update. But that's 6 weeks ago already. I think even more. It's already 6 weeks ago since we got a 64-bit update. Yeah, time flies. It's nice for B-Train as well, that more people are. Chris Shields is on the map as well. More and more people are starting to use it, which is awesome. Yeah, I got a better feeling by the, from this. The Exeter to Bristol part, I got a better feeling with how it's built here in the Southern Expressways than it is built in the Western Main Lines. But that's just a feeling. It's not one zillion forest and trees. It's just nice landscape. So, yeah. Not unsatisfied. And isn't that Devon to Cornwall also using this part of the rails? So we got now three versions? Or is that a bit further on? Is that past Exeter where Devon and Cornwall? That freeway route is growing and growing. It's really. It was already nice, but it's really becoming really, really nice. Let's slow down a bit. Yeah, we're gonna not gonna be on time anyway. Can't see him either. Guess he's still preparing. Let's hope it's not because we are too late. That would be such a shame. Oh yeah, Jelly, I need to. I've already made two huge mistakes today. You have a few visits, just. Ah, okay. Just sped it one time. I don't know if you were there. Full speed. Okay, it's approved. That is quite awesome. Final bang from Roscar. Static stuff. AI trains. is blue. Again, definitely impressed. And they have so many scenarios, so that's really cool. I think this is just the third or fourth scenario I'm playing from Oscar. So again, it doesn't end with Terrain Simulator. Amount of sheer content that has been built over the years. So yeah, we don't have an Unreal 4 engine. We don't have very beautiful smoke like the Unreal engine can do, but we have this. That's a kick in the nuts by Rosgar. Ouch. A little more practice, perhaps. I only sped it twice. it didn't count one out of six platforms. Well, that's okay. Oh, once. Yeah, only once in this journey. Player used emergency brake just four times. That's also correct. Penalty brakes were twice. Yeah. It wasn't one of the best. But oh my god, was it great. 122 kilometers. Just awesome. So like I said on their Facebook, I wrote on Rosgar Facebook last week when I finished the Virgin 47 scenario from them. Like, I'm not gonna spam your Facebook with each day that I'm gonna enjoy your one of your scenarios, but yeah, that's what I wrote. But I loved your 47 scenario on the West Coast Mainline over Shep, and then on the West Coast Mainline North. I said, so I'm looking forward to play more of your stuff. Yeah. It's definitely how I felt, I still do. So, 8 out of 10, legendary status, again. The next time is one, we're gonna do that on that recommendation by Jelly. And, that's... I think we got still time for that, and then that's a nice closure. So Sings has to wait for another day. It's that boom time on Scotland line, version 1 out of 6. He said you really gonna enjoy that one. That's the Western Scottish something line. West of Scotland lines, this should be the one. So we can skip all the steam, because that's something I will never drive anyway. Yeah, this is the Tobberg one. I still have to drive one day. It's not autistic friendly, but Jelly, I did what I said, and I kicked the 37 out. I kicked it from the earth, and that's the only thing I changed. I switched it to a class 47. So. Sorry to Coasty. I know he meant this scenario to be played with the 37, but I was like, hey, I wanna play it, but on my terms. And that's 45 minutes. Well, that's cool. So I can do that. At least I think I don't know what's in store for me. I think it's not gonna be a point A to point B drive. And what people have saying it's something with instructions. Yeah, we'll see. Let's hope so, Jelly. Today you support the local teams by taking over some duties. You just arrived from Manchester via Penrith and are about to approach Carlisle to deliver diesel for the local fleet. Once you have released your load, you will pick up cementary wagons and bring them to East Rick. It's early morning. Yeah, hence you may expect quite some traffic around you. That is cool. So watch speed and signals. Oh, but that's no problem for me. Speed and signals. Let's see how this goes, Jelly. Yeah, if it's gonna bring the scenario or the script, don't blame Coasty. But let's hope that I can do it with the 47. And I'm bringing a reskinned 47 from the first Virgin pack. I'm taking that 47. So it's not the European Asset 47, but the Virgin First Generation pack 47 with a green reskin. Yeah, I think it's gonna work as well, Jenny. We're bound by speed restrictions anyway, so it's not like I'm gonna be a rocket instead of compared to the 37. Speed wise and with the restrictions, I don't think it's gonna break. And at least I hope. But it's a simulator, but I also want to have a bit of fun. And for me, a 47 doubles the fun. Well, we're starting off with a I think I can. Oh yeah, always download the complete rebranding and what's the other one? Extra stock, yeah. Today, yeah, look, this is the picture of the 37. You support the local teams, but that's what we already know. That's all you know as well. Your local just got modified. Indeed, it did. Oh, but it's equipped with a speed limiter. Set to 50 miles an hour. This is the maximum speed for your wagons. Okay, I will kind of remember that as well. You are pulling a heavy terrain, so accelerate smoothly. As otherwise, wheel slip may become an issue. Yeah, I'm mostly off like a throttle up. Proceed if the signal allows. All right. Then we need two things. Synchronize the clock and clear the third wheels map. Well, clearing the third wheels map is just one click. And what time do we have in game? 07:38. 07:38. That's going to be our clock as well. You're going for a 37/4 freight run. On the Fort William line. Yeah, the 37, hey, it's not a... Lots of people adore that train. It's really a nice train. There's nothing bad with a good 37. Yeah, you're going from Bristol to Carlisle route, right? I see we are close to Carlisle ourselves at the moment. So I'll definitely see you on the map once you start. Now we need to wait to 38:25. Yeah, that's not the biggie.
Are you ready? Let's get ready to rumble!
Speed limit is active. All right. Where's my headlight? Or instrument light? Cap heater? No. Demister. That's the instrument lights. Now, oh, that's cool. Headlights are already on. Reverse forwards. Oh yeah, yeah. Watch out for wheel slip and ooh, the noise. That's even too much. So if the in-game sound is too loud compared to the microphone, I got a feeling this train is even louder than the 52 we were driving before. What are we holding? Oh no, please. Don't tell me you dumped. No. Did something happen with the keyboard? Oh, thank goodness. We are holding... this. And a little thingy. Okay. Oh. There's a nice sound effect. You close down the throttle. Yeah, this is definitely another 47 than the European asset pack. A bit of speeding. The tanker wagons and a brake cam. There's another, I think I can. Oh, these are those checking signals that will go green when once you drive over. Wow, sound wise, wow. This is so let's hope this one also turns green. Yeah, it does. Oh, look, the bell sound. So yeah. We still got the same little diesel sound going on there. I think I found myself a new 47 here. Go via London Road Gate. Yeah, this gives more than the feeling of I'm driving something ancient than the European Asset Pack 47. Of course, most of the times with those packs, you're always buying reskin stuff. But this is really a different model as well. Reduce speed to 50 miles when you reach the next signal. Okay. Then stop in front of the free workers. Okay, next signal is still a bit ahead. Is this full headlights? Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. Okay, reduce speed to 50. Yeah, another terrain. To my opinion, I don't need the sound pack for. If there is any, I don't know, but this already sounds good to me. Oh wow, yeah. Nice AI. Full with static stuff. Shifter there. Hello boys. There we are. The switch is already set, so move reverse and uncouple all wagons. We are not timetabled. I hear another steam. Yeah. This is much more fun than I did have fun with the long journeys with the 43 from Plymouth to London, and I'm definitely gonna do that again. But this is a different ballgame. This is totally my thing. Oh, don't go too fast, please. There they are. Thank you guys. Thumbs up. You switched to the correct. No, I can't be in this. Uh-oh, now I screwed up. I switched. Yeah. I shouldn't have done that. Now, I hope we can fix this problem. Yeah, we can. At least we're on the right side now. If you're running into any problems, Paul. There are some experienced train simmer here, so just ask, you know, if something isn't working out. And I don't mean myself, but there are some people really have good knowledge about train sim and stuff. We have some kind of name. Traction Magazine. That's not good. How's it going, Katie? I hope it's working out a bit. Okay, we had to decouple all the stuff. Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh, no. I'm so bad at this. Set the fifth... Yeah, no. If I stop Once I click this away, I'm gonna forget. I'm already forgot everything. Set the fifth switch in front of you as per the image on the left. Ah, it's got an arrow as well. Thank goodness. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Paul and Owen are there as well in case you need help. Then proceed to Durringen. Down siding 2 and couple all wagons to the front of your loco. Yeah. First I'm gonna click this. I wanna get rid of the dead, yes. At least we're in post, but that's cool. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that needs to be switched to the north. Proceed to Durham Hill down siding 2. I got you. One, two, three, four, five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not really. Check. This is 3. This is 2. That is 2. No, don't reverse. Here we go. You got anything rolling with you got it working, Katie? Devin and Cornwell? Maybe you already replied and she's doing hard labor, installing all the stuff. Yeah, it is sometimes some routes can be such a pain, but then again, it's so much worth it. Ah, let's hope for the best, Katie. Are we there yet? Nope. Yeah, we are there. Okay, task complete. Change cap. Set the switch directly in front of you to head back to the main track. Proceed your journey. With check signal before. Yes, I'm ready. It's pretty busy. Change cap. Switch stuff. Okay. Change cap. Check. Warning, the brake train valve A end is not properly shut down. Train brake valve locked in his cabin until it's shut down. Yeah. Okay. And this should be the instrument lights. Yes. Warning, the train brake Yeah, indeed. I can't do a thing now. It was complaining about the brake. Off. Brakes off. Okay, are you satisfied now? No, the drain brake valve in the other end is not properly shut down. Train brake valve locked in this cab until it is shut down. Oh. Yeah, yeah. I think we need to call Houston. The brake valve thingy. Has not been shut down correctly. Oh, maybe it's a locomotive brake? No, it is shut down as well. We are on zero. Looks good to me. The AWS change end lever is still open. Please close it. AWS change end lever. Right, close it. Maybe master key. Fire alarm overload. Change end lever is still open. In A. In the other end. Please close it. Warning, the drain brake valve end is not properly shut down. You can't do a thing until it's been properly. I think I can't. Wiper switch, no, that's not gonna help. Reverser is off. Brakes are down. Maybe next time read the manual. I'm quite clueless. Handbrake off. Got a bit of a problem here, Jelly. Stop the engine. But the sounds are cool. That's not a solution either. An AWS change end lever is still open. Can I press the alarm button? There are no more buttons. Tail light, demister, dash light, marker light, cap heater, foot warmer, complement light. Okay, that can't be. That's a light dimmer. This is probably another wiper. This is a horn. And what's this over here? Train heat. Gonna help us eat them. I think I first need to read the manual. And then try this again. Yeah, otherwise we're gonna be stuck here now. This is not gonna work. An AWS. I can try. Right. Let me see. Steam Common, Railworks, Manuals, English. I'm looking for the version 47. Class 47 network now Southeast. No, that's not the correct one. Virgin Trains, first generation pack manual. All right. Let's see if there's anything there. Change end procedure, page 12. To change ends in this loco, you must follow the change end procedure. Pressing Control plus 7 will give you a walkthrough of how to shut down the cap you are in. Pressing Control and 8 will give you a walkthrough of how to start up the cap you move into. The C key on the keyboard will take out the master key and drop the AWS change end lever. Right. There you go. Hey, Molenaar.
Waarom ben ik Molenaar geworden?
Hey man, goedenavond.
Hoe gaan de mensen leven?
We're quite stuck here at the moment a bit. Hope you're doing fine. We're stuck with our 47. Right, let's first start the engines again. I hope you're doing fine, Molenaar. Alright. To change ends in this loco, you must follow the change end procedure, pressing Control plus 7. Will give you a walkthrough of how to shut down the cap you are in. Control plus 7. Oh my goodness. Apply straight air brake, then move train brake handle to emergency. Check. If necessary, switch off headlights and marker lights and turn on tail lights. That's actually not a bad idea. And why am I now on the last part of the train? That's already fixed. No, I need to be on the other side. This is the correct side. Emergency is applied. Okay, we're gonna assume the headlights are off. Yeah, but give me the rundown. Move reverser to off and take out the master key. That's already done. Close the AWS change end handle. There we go. Hey Rutger, goedenavond. Good to see you. Yeah, we're running a little bit problem here. Trying to change ends on the 47. Close the AWS change end handle. Yeah, can you make it more cryptic? An AWS change end handle. Manual, help. AWS. Was it the change end lever? I think we're running into a bit of a problem here. Close the AWS change end handle. AWS change end lever is the C button. Yeah. That's number 32. That should be over there. Gee, come on. I just wanna swap the well, release the straight air brake and ensure brake cylinder pressure remains constant. Release the straight air brake. This is more complicated than a 460. And now I'm pressing all the wrong buttons here. What again? Release straight air brake and ensure brake cylinder pressure stays. Straight air brake. What is a straight air brake? Doesn't say. Okay, we can assume that's okay. Turn off the. Hello? Please. Give me the checklist. Turn off the cab auxiliaries such as heaters and lights. Yeah, that's okay. Oh yeah, now okay, we can switch off the this light. Right on. Now we've got a switch. Nope. The AWS change at lever is still open. Right, there you go. There you go. I think we got him. Yes. But now, where's the master key? Press Control 8 for the checklist. Wasn't it? Pressing Control 8 will give you a walkthrough of how to start up the cab you are moving into. The C key on the keyboard will take out the master key and drop the C key. Nothing happened. Oh, 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 I hear something. Yeah. We got a forward, I think. Yeah, we're not done yet. Need to find the main route in this main in this maze. Oh come on, are you see? Carlisle Goods Line C. Oh my god. You're kidding me. That's not gonna work. Okay, let's switch this one. Oh, that is a different ball game. Yeah. Yeah. That's it. Well, we lost, I think, 30 minutes there. Okay, let's put the chat back on the second screen. At least I can see what you are saying again all. Yeah, where's the mask key? Yeah, it's a C. This is why I like shooting scenarios, a puzzle. Oh. Oh, really? I guess that's. Puzzle it is. Okay, let's roll. 1 mile. We are totally empty, right? No. put those things on my train. Yeah, I hope they are good scenarios. I think they, yeah, probably they are basically all custom. So that's cool. There's also already a good amount of scenarios to start with. I hope to find a... Yeah, I still got one scenario for the Birmingham 2010. Oh, it's... I'm overflowing with content. For this game. So much I still want to drive. That's a car. Yeah, that's a car. Oh, that's all. It's all going for McDonald's. Wow, that's a lot of hamburgers. Oh, I've never seen these carriages or these things before. Wow. A lot of meat. Beefsteaks. Ah. I think those. The pictures I see of the steaks in the US. Ah. That's really. That's how a steak should be. What is a T-bone steak? Oh my god. Big and really big. But yeah, they love everything big over there. Really awesome. Yeah, I'm sorry if there's a vegetarian. Yeah, I'm sorry. I can agree, they are so treating the animals so badly. Expect to stop as you have to follow a class 101 with high priority. Keep an eye on signals. Yeah, but I think we gotta stop first. No, it's a Govia. I think that 101 is long gone. We're having so much delay. Actually, it could be that one. But as long as everything is green, I'm just gonna continue doing my thing. Because I can't imagine that 101 still being here. Why am I on the wrong side of the train? When I go outside, please. Okay, I'll switch here. Wow. Yeah. What a website. Go via Keldu Junction down Main. Well, at least I don't have to switch anything now. Yeah. I think it's harder to make a good cargo scenario than passenger service. Because with passenger service you have some kind of clue where the player is arriving at a given moment, you know. You got a timetable like, okay, he's gonna stop at that station. But with cargo and shunting, you also have people like me who will take just 30 minutes figuring out how to drive and who are slower or faster. Yeah, that's a different ballgame. Of course, 30 minutes, this was really bad. But some people are just way faster in figuring out stuff. How to shunt quicker than others. And it has to work for everyone. Scenario. Mile drive, that's nice. And what are we transporting, by the way? Oh yeah, the cement. Yeah. Heavy stuff. Yeah, for me this is 10 times more fun than driving a class 43 on a 3-hour journey. That horse car scenario was awesome, this one as well. Keeps you busy. Instead of just washing the rails. Molenaar, thank you very much for joining, man. You as well, sleep well. Yeah, with all this delay, my stream is running later than expected, but I'm gonna make this to the end. Thank you for joining, Molenaar. Auto brakes are old. Ah, that's the 50 mile limit. Yeah. I understand, speed limiter. Instructions told me so. Don't exceed 50. Everything. And this is also not a bad line. West Scotland. So yeah, it's all stuff I bought in the monster sale. I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna buy and buy and buy and buy, and I'll see when I drive them. Look at that. Another, I think I can. Very nice era. I think we got the 101 there. If that, no, it's no, it's heading this way. That 101 is long. Shall we take a look? That 101 that we should have been waiting on. Yeah, that is already, he's already went to a portal when we departed. So where's Paul driving, or is my... Oh, I see him there. Oh, he went way up north. That's Scotland, definitely Scotland, no doubt about that. Yes, they do. I was just halted by auto brakes. I was like, what is happening here? And then I reminded, oh yeah, I can't go I was reminded like, oh yeah, of course I can't go faster than 50. Let's do it one more time. It's not career anyway. Yeah, it did. So the first 5 seconds I was wondering what happened. It start breaking at 50.6. No, it was a little bit over it then. Yeah, here we go. All the brakes on. So definitely here. So they did their job. All the brakes off. So that's cool. So it even works with a 47. Yeah, that's CK Gaming is hosting the scenario for... Hello CK Gaming, thank you again for the host, man. Thank you a lot. And everybody who is watching CK, welcome as well. Doing the final part of the boom time on Scotland, and I was just gonna mention again to the people watching. Oh, whistle. I'm not playing it as it was intended by Coasty. It was intended for a 37, but it's a simulator, and but it's also a game, and I really wanted to do it in a 47. So if anybody is like, hey, what's wrong with this scenario, it's because I just changed to 37. Yeah, this is only the first part. It's a 6-1. Yeah. It's a 6-part journey. And oh my god, did I struggle with this part? Before this, I did the Roscar scenario on the Just Range Southern Expressways, and that was, this one is amazing, but the Roscar one as well. I mean, it's the old diesel era. I love it, and what Roscar is doing with their scenarios, and Coasty is the same. This is my first Coasty. Really, really nice. Okay, we're gonna change track. And we're playing in the reskinned version of the 47 from the Virgin first generation back. And actually, now I'm driving it for the first time. Really, really nice. It's not just a reskin of the European asset pack, is really a new Model 47. Awesome sounds. Of course, that's so much with the Dovetail games. You buy a pack and it's just basically a reskin. But no, the Virgin First Generation 47. Total different ballgame. Yeah, we're too late anyway now. So. Not gonna worry about 30 more seconds delay. Govia, and after the Govia, oh, it's not over yet. Another Govia, then a stop, then another stop, and then drop off the cargo. All right, should be doable. Oh, did we just enter Scotland? I think we did. We just got informed that a defective train is blocking the main track after Gretna Station. Fortunately, you are able to get around it. Prepare to slow down to 50 miles an hour and leave the main track right after Gretna Station at half a mile from here. Okay. I'm just gonna assume they are doing the switching. Prepare to slow down to 50 miles an hour and leave the main track right. Hey! I think so too. Thank you for the tip, Jelly. There we go again. I'm able to find a scenario I can play on it, as I need an AP. I hope so. Okay, we need a break. MK3, that's the 90, right? Yeah, it is a 90. What's going on there? Got all the people. She, what an adventure. Okay, I'm not gonna scare jump him with a horn. Wow. Please don't tell me it's a 47. No, it isn't. Yeah, that explains. They used the wrong engine. Nine-nine-four, welcome back. Great job so far. Now continue your journey as planned, and you'll be able to have breakfast soon. How was the Sims today, 9-9-4? I noticed you were quite enjoying it. And that's the good thing about the Sims. There's always stuff to do. Yeah, 9 hours. Yeah, it feels like a progression. I don't know how many hours my father has in Sim 3, but he's still not. I think he's played for 3 years now, still Sim 3. There's so much content in the Sims games. Yeah, 3 was amazing. I mean, those adventures. You could go to Egypt and to France. And that's just one expansion pack. Yeah, I watched until 7:30. But that was like, yeah, I'm gonna do some train sim, you know. I definitely made quite a bit of progress since I started today, and 3 was the best. 3 was awesome. The big towns where you could just move without going to the edge of a map. You could just go anywhere in the town. Ah, CK Gaming, hello. I would go for 3. I think for the people who are... Yeah, I would definitely go for 3. Yeah, I think that's... You worded it correctly. Cheers to you as well, CK. Thank you again for the host. If you were somewhere else and you missed it, thank you again, man. Really appreciate it. Yeah, once you get used to 3, 4 is just it feels like a social media game. And in 3 you can do so much. You can do so much in 3. Yeah, and if you don't buy them on Origin. Oh, they're speeding. You can buy the expansions for Sims 3. If you don't buy them on Origins, you can buy them quite cheaply. So that's quite cool. Of course, yeah, Sims is always getting better with expansions. Yeah, but I think, like my dad, he went for Origins for the Sims. The most keys that you can buy are for the expansions are for Origins. The cheaper ones, that is, of course. Yeah, I had an amazing evening. With Oscar. And now this. And of course with you guys in the chat. What a fun to drive. Like I said, I didn't mind yesterday driving the 43. A long journey. But this is... Yeah, this is so different. Oh, is access for a year or so? Get that. Yeah. That's the access part. Oh, that's cool. Yeah. Yeah, you also built. The Sims 3 expansions are insanely cheap if you don't buy them on Origins. What game is that, 994? No, I know. Never mind. You don't have to type it. I think I know what game. Yeah, people are really enjoying that new route in the US. But what did Scotty say? It does have some bugs. It's quite a shame. Yeah, I was afraid. I was like, oh no, let's just clarify that. Long Island Railroads, yeah. Believe it or not, there's another train blocking the main track right after East Rig Station. Fortunately, you need to stop at the siding anyway, but be attentive as there might be passengers around the track. Stop at siding East Rig Loop before you go reverse to your final destination in the car. Yes, we will do. Gotcha. Gonna drive very slow. Honestly, I think for me it will be one of the last countries on the list. I got a bit UK, then the Netherlands, then Germany, then Swiss and Austria, and then somewhere comes the US. Well, I'm gonna have a good start with the US because lots of routes came with 2018 and Train Simulator 2019 and Train Simulator I don't know what year. So at least route wise I will have a nice start, and it's the same with Germany. Of course I don't have them all, but at least a good amount. Yeah, let's proceed slowly now. Don't want to scare those passengers. They really need to go out of the train? Ooh, that's scary stuff. Do we want to scare him? Yeah, let's do a small one. I think you... Oh, Mr. Passenger, watch out. I think it was a good idea. Blow the... this is wow. Yeah. Now I see what you mean, Jelly. That's really worth a recommendation, yeah. Boom time on Scotland. Out of memory error on TSW with 16 gigabyte of RAM. That's surprising. The instruction was reverse and dump our cargo. Yes, we are fully on the yellow. I'm gonna assume we have... Yes, this is far enough. We reverse to somewhere and stop there. The switches are already set. Oh, thank you so much. so that you may proceed straight away. It's quite a distance to get there, so keep contact to your buddy in the brake van, as he will keep an eye on the track. Well, you are going in reverse, exactly. The local crew is expecting you already and deciding, yeah, they are waiting there more than 30 minutes. They definitely are expecting me now. Okay, reverse. Yeah, that's weird. It puts me on the wrong side of the cabin. Ah, this side is the correct side. I mean the front and the rear. This looks like the rear. It's quite a distance, he said. Yeah, it's 1 mile. Go to the brake van. Uh-oh. Oh, please, no. Please don't stop. No, he doesn't stop. Okay, we can't do it the way I want it. So we're just gonna use the 3 key then. Or the 2. Yeah, the 2 key. Oh, the 5 key. Way to go, Jelly. Thank you. Wow. Nice. Yes, we can swap sides as well. And look at that. Shunter over there. Okay, I hope he switched the correct one. That's a long 1 mile. Accelerate that much. That for his team workshop scenario. Now with stuff like this, you don't need to buy scenario packs. This is, yeah, really good. Oh, there's Bob. Yeah. Bob and Hank. we will go straight on. Yeah. So, there's 5 more parts to go. If they are all this quality, then we just struck gold. Yeah, let's use the disky now. Let's take a quick look from above. What are you showing there? British Railways. Yeah. Yeah, this is good enough, eh? Let's make it so. Yes. Uncoupled. Well done, mate. Well done. Complete snow successfully. Good time to enjoy a solid breakfast and then proceed to part two. Well, nice scripting. That's really nice. Of course, thumbs up. And that's definitely worth a comment on the Steam Workshop Coasty. And the easy part is I'll just have to click, go to the workshop and select a subscribed item. So I'll be there in 20 seconds later this evening. I'm going to do that off stream, of course. And then just tell them how I felt. And it was awesome. Edwin, I agree. I had, yeah. This is the Rosgar and this one both. I love them both. So thank goodness. April proof it to 47. Hey, this model is I'll never go back to the European asset pack. 47 now. I loved it. And yeah. I loved having you as well. Thank you for the recommendation, Jelly. Because it's the Steam Workshop is so filled with scenarios. Yeah. So I still have 5 parts to go. Yeah. It doesn't end. Train Simulator 2019. Amount of content, scenarios, routes. Yeah. Really nice. Thank you everybody for being here. I hope you liked the stream. I definitely enjoy doing it, playing these scenarios, and with you guys in the chat, it always is such a joy. Katie, good luck if you're still here. Good luck with getting everything to run over there with the reskins and all the stuff. Thank you as well for being. You're still here. Wow, nice. Thank you very much, Katie. Yeah, I can mention everyone. I'll mention CK as well, of course. Thank you for the host, CK. Thank you for being here, everybody else. And yeah, next time we're gonna play. There's so much still to do. I got a top burg, I got a sinks, I got part 5 to 6. Yes, you're welcome. And thank you for being, Edwin. Paul, good luck with your journey. And I hope to see you guys next time.